Dear students, today we are going to discuss a few problems on power amplifier. This is about class B power amplifier. So I'll point out very important parameter here. See, the power which is given here, the problem is 50 watts. For the circuit, the load resistor is 24. Okay, the input symmetrical input sine wave. So what we want to find here, first you want to think, what you want to find? First, you want to find what is the supply voltage for the given circuit. So they are not given the supply voltage, we need to find what is the supply voltage for the given circuit. What is the condition they have given in the problem? The supply voltage are to be at least 3 voltage greater than the maximum output voltage. This is the condition. So this is a very important hint they have given for you. So what is the formula you know? That is P equal to 1 by 2 V square P divided by RL. Vp is nothing but a peak voltage. So what is the power which is given in the problem? 50. So 50 equal to 1 by 2 V square P divided by 24. If you rearrange, you will be getting 49 voltage. So this is a peak voltage we got for this circuit. Now we want to find what is the supply. So the given in the statement, it should be greater than the maximum output voltage, at least 3. Plus 3 I have to add, right? So I have added plus 3. So 52. So you have a 52 voltage, that is for this given circuit. Then I want to find what is your peak current in your device. Okay, what is the formula you know? That is Vp equal to Ip into RL. So that is a peak voltage equal to peak current into load resistor. So peak current equal to peak voltage divided by load resistor. So 49 divided by 24, you will be getting 2.04 amps. So third question is, what is the conversion efficiency? So we want to find the conversion efficiency in terms of percentage, that is eta equal to pi by 4 Vp by Vcc. So you know what is the peak voltage, you have determined in the last term. So just substitute, just plug in this Vp here. So you will be finding the 74%. Okay, so this is a percentage of efficiency for this given circuit. I hope you understood, we will go for next problem. See, in this problem, actually they designing class B push-pull amplifier with the loudspeaker of 8 ohms, okay, with the loudspeaker of 8 ohms, the resistance. You know already the resistance in the output side will be very less in the power amplifier. You want to maintain. The input impedance will be very large. I said we discussed in the last lecture also, why we want to keep less and more in the input side. Right, the turns ratio, N1, N2, that is 4 by 1, the efficiency of 95%. So what you want to find here is what is the maximum power output, what is the maximum power dissipation, and what is your maximum base current of each transistor. That is a thing you have to find. So beta equal to 15 and supply voltage equal to 24. Now we will see a basic, that is about a turns ratio. So this is a primary winding, this is a secondary winding, N1 and N2. This is RL dash, that is a mirror intent of load. V2 is a drop across the secondary winding part. So V2 is nothing but I can write like N2 by N1 into V1. So that is a V2 by V1 equal to N2 by N1. Similarly, when you write for current ratio, that is I2 by I1 equal to N1 by N2, reverse of this. Impedance ratio, that is RL dash divided by RL. So that is R1 by R2. So I can write like N1 by N2 whole square. It is A square. So N1 by N2 is nothing but a A. So now we will find for this specific problem. What is they asking? The first question, they are asking to find what is the maximum power output, right? So how you will find the maximum like a AC power output? You want to find AC power output, right? So like a PAC max equal to 1 by 2 V square M divided by RL. That is a peak voltage. So you are not specified any peak voltage, right? So we are given the maximum voltage in the terms of DC only, VCC only they given. So I am modifying this equation as 1 by 2 V square CC divided by RL dash. Okay, RL dash. Okay, now I want to find RL dash. What is RL dash? RL dash is nothing but a, that is R1 divided by R2 into whole square into RL. So that this part, this is RL dash, right? So if you find, finally we'll be getting 128. This 4 is nothing but a 4 by 1. With the help of the turns ratio we are finding. This 4, then this is a 1. Now we want to find what is our maximum AC power. We have got RL dash, just plug in here. So that is 1 by 2, 24 square divided by 128, you will be getting 2.25 watts. Now we want to find what is your maximum DC power dissipation. So how we can find, you know the formula, 2 by pi square V square CC divided by RL dash. So just plug in the values, 2 into 24 whole square divided by pi square into 128, you will be getting 0.12 watts. Now I want to find for per transistor. Okay, so you can find, so that is divided by 2, that is the maximum power dissipation in each transistor. So you will be getting 0.56 watts. Okay, next we want to find what is the maximum base current. Okay, so we know the formula, that is PAC equal to Vm into Im divided by 2. Okay, that is Vm by root 2 into Im by root 2. You know, right, that is for Vm by root 2 into Im by root 2, it gives Vm Im by 2. So here comes this formula. Then I have changed Vm into VCC. So you got this modified equation. I have just plug in the known values. You got Im, right? So Im, you got it, that's it. So I want to find the Ib. How you can find, you know the relation, Ic equal to beta times of Ib. So I have rearranged like Ib equal to Ic by beta. So that is Ic, it is a peak voltage I can take. So that is a beta. So 0.1875 divided by 15, you will be getting 12.5 milliamps. So this is a maximum base current for the given circuit. Okay, so this problem completed. So I hope you understood. Next we'll go for the third problem. See, in this third problem, this is a complementary symmetry class B amplifier. Very important, you should use the two transistor. It should have the matched characteristics and dual power supply and the input VRMS of 8. Then another thing is the CC configuration. So you know that V out is approximately equal to V in. With that input, I am writing V naught RMS equal to VI RMS equal to 8 voltage. Here we want to calculate what is the DC power input, AC power output, efficiency, what is the power dissipation of each transistor. So very simple problem. You need to know only the formulas. If you know the formulas, if you understand that sentence, you can solve the problem very easily. So VRMS equal to Vm into root 2. What is the Vm? You know the formula, right? VRMS equal to Vm by root 2. We want to find what is the peak voltage. Vm equal to VRMS into root 2. What is the VRMS? VRMS is 8 into root 2. It gives 11.317 voltage. Now I want to find what is the peak current. This Im equal to output peak voltage divided by RL. That gives 1.4142 amps. That's it. Now we want to calculate what is the DC power output power. Very simple. PDC equal to VCC into 2Im by pi. Just plug in the known values. All values are known. You will be getting 27 watts. Similarly, you have to find for AC output power. That is 1 by 2 V square peak voltage. That is a peak voltage square divided by RL. So you will be getting 7.9 watts. So now you want to find efficiency. That is 7.9 divided by 27. You will be getting 29 efficiency. Only 29% efficiency is very poor efficiency. Based on the circuit, based on the resistance, and we will be getting this power dissipation. Okay, here efficiency is very less for this problem. So we need to increase, we can increase the efficiency by modifying the circuit. So power dissipation per transistor, this is for overall. For per transistor, how you can find, that is at DC minus AC divided by 2. So DC is 27, AC is 7.9 divided by 2, you will be getting 9.55 watts. So if you look at this problem, consider the transformer coupled emitter follower in the figure. So we have seen many problems in the class A amplifier. So in the class A amplifier, what are the problems we have covered? Like one is RC based coupling, like a resistance and capacitive based coupling, then inductance based coupling, then transformer based coupling. The drawback of inductance based coupling will be rectified in the transformer coupled amplifier. But whatever you have seen before, that was this transformer was connected in the emitter part. Now this was connected in the collector. Whatever you have seen before, that was collected in the collector part, right? Now it was connected in the emitter part. This is the emitter follower. Okay, so this configuration is an emitter follower because you are taking your output in the emitter section and you are giving the input in the base section. So this is a divider biasing R1 R2. Your supply voltage is 12. So this is a turns RL dash you have to consider, and this is RL. This is output current. So turns ratio is 10 by 1. So that is 10, right? So I have rearranged this part, okay, for my analysis. So like a by Thevenin's, this can be a load, right? So once you remove this supply, this R1 will come parallel, you got it. Then that is source, I have removed the DC, right? So this will come parallel to this R1. So current across this base is IB. Then this current across this, that is RL dash I have considered. That is a resistance across this primary winding, so I have taken as RL dash. How you got this 800? That is RL dash is nothing but A square into RL. So what is A square? 10 into 8. So that is 800 about RL dash. That's it. So now here you want to understand, here is, this is for AC and this is for DC. In the AC, here you are using the load as a inductor. That is using the inductor, I made the transformer, right? So generally the inductor will oppose the change of current. So due to that you have a higher resistance. This is a load line you can see. For the DC you don't have any resistance. You have a very small resistance, that is you can see here. Okay, so this is a quotient point. So maximum swing is 2ICQ. Similarly for here, maximum output swing is 2VCC. So the center voltage, that is a quotient point, is VCC. So very important, you have to noting. Similarly here your center current is, quotient current is ICQ. So this is also very important. So now we will go for the problem. So see, first they have written I equal to 1 plus beta IB. How they got? So I equal to IB plus IC, right? So I equal to IB. IC I can write like a beta times of IB. So IB I can take like a 1 plus beta. So this comes here, it's formula. Then IB, by using current divider rule, you can see here, I want to find here, okay, I have applied the current divider rule. See, if you apply the current divider rule, what you will get? R1 parallel to R2 divided by R1 parallel to R2 plus RIB. That is a total resistance into your source current. Okay, here, see carefully. I want to find across this. So what is the opposite resistance? This one, it is R1 parallel to R2 divided by R1 parallel to R2 plus RIB, okay, into your source current. So you will be getting your base current. Okay, so now you can substitute this IB here. So if you substitute, this can be written as IE by IA equal to 1 plus beta R1 parallel to R2 divided by R1 parallel to R2 plus RIB. So this is a basic formula you studied already. That is resistance in the base, that is internal base resistance, you can calculate by R pi is internal base resistance, 1 plus beta RL dash. So this part, okay, this part. So this part we are writing R pi plus 1 plus beta into RL dash. So you know, so here this formula can be approximately written like 1 plus beta RL dash. So that is 1 plus 100 into RL dash will get 80.8, right? See, now you got a RIB. now we can solve this equation. The given problem, you can see it is a current gain. It was given like a 8. So IE by II. So same you can see in this formula. So IE by II. So it is written as 8 equal to 101. So R1 parallel to R2 divided by R1 parallel to R2 plus 80.8. So once you rearrange this equation, you will be getting R1 parallel to R2 divided by R1 parallel to R2 plus 80.8 equal to 0.0792. Okay, so I can rearrange. Here. So you will be getting R1 parallel to R2 equal to 0.0792 into R1 parallel to R2 plus 80.8. So take this part to the left side and rearrange. You will be getting R1 parallel to R2 equal to 6.94 kilo ohms. So this is the R1 parallel to R2 value. So very important. See, now you know that the maximum swing is 2VCC and maximum swing here is 2ICQ. Right? So I can take that and I have solved, that is RL dash. So you know that the changes of voltage by changes of output current. So you will be getting RL dash. So RL dash, right? So that I can rewrite like a, that is ICQ. So I just rearrange this equation. The ICQ equal to VCC by RL dash, that is 12 by 0.8 equal to 15 milliamps. Now you come to the basic. We want to find R1 and R2. How you can find? So proceed with the basic formula. IC equal to beta times of IB. So IBQ equal to 15 by 100. Right? You will be getting 0.15 milliamps. When you apply the KVL in the input part, right here, when you apply the KVL after taking the Thevenin's theorem, so this part ETH, IB, you can see this part, okay, that is a VTH equal to IBQ RTH plus VB, okay. So now what is RTH? Okay, so I'm writing like a this VTH. VTH I can write like a VTH, you know formula for VTH, that is VCC into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Okay, so I can rewrite because I don't know the all values are unknown. In order to find it, I am just rewriting like this one, like R1 to R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So both are same, right? So this come here. So this one you know already, you found out 6.94 here, 95 mistake, 94. So you just rearrange, you will be getting 47 point kilo ohm. So now you know one value got R1. So now very simple to get R2, right? From RTH equal to R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Just plug in all values, rearrange and multiply this value, this 6.95k, and rearrange this equation, you will be getting R2 equal to 8.10 kilo ohm. Right, I hope this problem clear. Okay, so like we got R1, R2, right? Now what is the efficiency we have to find, right? That is a problem, last question they asked. So like the magnitude of signal emitter current is limited to 0.9 ICQ to prevent distortion. So determine the power delivered to the load and the conversion efficiency. So how you can find, that is the problem itself they given, that is 0.9, that is ICQ, that is your DC point just happened to swing. So IE equal to 0.9 ICQ, you will be getting 13.5 milliamps. Okay, the load current you know you are getting in the emitter part, right? So I can write based on the turns only you'll be getting your current, right? So IL equal to A into IE, that gives 135 milliamps. So you want to find what is the load power and you want to find that is the source power. So load power by source power, you'll be getting conversion efficiency. So load power equal to 1 by 2, that is I square into RL. So I square is nothing but 135 milliamps, the return in terms of amps 0.135, right? So into 8, so you'll be getting 72.9 milliwatts, right? Similarly, you can find for source power. So VCC into ICQ, so you'll be getting 180 milliwatts. Substitute, you'll be getting 40.5%. So this is also very similar problem. You can try it. So here you can see the loudspeaker resistance was 4 ohm for this class B push-pull amplifier. The power is 2 watts. You want to calculate the turns, right? Turns, you know already what you mean by turn, we have solved. If VCC is 12 and transformer is ideal, so given values I have written, so you know the formula, that is a PAC max equal to 1 by 2 V square M by RL square. That can be written like V square CC into 2 RL dash. So now I want to find RL dash, that is RL dash equal to A. A is nothing but a N1 by N2 square into RL. So from this, RL dash was given in the problem, right? So RL dash, we need to find. How we can find RL dash is nothing but a V square CC divided by 2 AC max. Okay, so from this you can find what is the supply voltage. Supply voltage, it was given like a 12. So 12, okay, AC max. What is the AC power? 2. So 2 into 2, you will be getting this value, that is 36 ohms. Then you got RL dash, so just plug in and you can find the RL, right? So you want to find the turns, right? So N1 by N2, so N1 by N2 whole square equal to 9. So the final value will be N1 by N2 equal to 3, right? So this is a 10 turns ratio they are asking for this problem.